गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. सो दिस इज़ आवर फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल डिज़ाइन 1 एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज वर्किंग स्ट्रेस मेथड. सो वर्किंग स्ट्रेस मेथड इज़ ए पर्टिकुलर डिज़ाइन मेथड. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस डिज़ाइन मेथड फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस सम फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल डिज़ाइन. So first we will discuss what is a structure. So all of you know that structure is an assembly of number of members such as your slab, beam, column, wall, etc. And they are proportioned in such a manner that they can resist the loads and forces coming over it. Next one is design of a structure. So design includes assessment of the loads and providing members of sufficient proportions to resist that assessed load along with sufficient margin of safety. So that is a design. What do you mean by an effective design? So effective design, a design is said to be effective one if the members are arranged in such a manner that they can transmit their self weight and other imposed load to the foundation by the cheapest mean so as to satisfy the requirement of architecture, structural stability along with sufficient safety. So that design is considered to be an effective one. Then what is the objective of design and detailing? Every structure must be designed to satisfy three basic requirements. So the first requirement is stability. Stability of a structure is to prevent the overturning, sliding or buckling under the action of the load. So the first objective of the design is stability. Second one is strength. Strength means strength to resist safely the stresses which are induced by the loads in various structural members. Third one is serviceability. So serviceability is to ensure satisfactory performance under service load condition. And serviceability include two parameters. One is deflection and second one is cracking. So deflection should be limited so as to ensure better appearance of the structure and to prevent cracking. And second parameter is cracking. So the cracking of the reinforced concrete structure or the structure should not be excessive to ensure better appearance and also to prevent the access of water from the cracks. Okay, so if water will enter into the structure, then that may corrode the reinforcement. So these are the two parameters of serviceability. One is deflection, second one is cracking. Then this structural design one, this your structural design 1 deals with design of RCC structure. And RCC structure, all of you know that RCC structure means it is reinforced cement concrete structure. So reinforced cement concrete structure is a combination of concrete and steel. Okay, as your concrete is no doubt good in compression, but it is weak in resisting tension. Therefore, in order to enhance its strength in tension zone, we have introduced steel with concrete, and these concrete and steel have a good bond because they have nearly or approximately equal thermal coefficient. Okay, therefore steel is used in combination with concrete, so that is known as a RCC structure. Next, we will discuss about the grades of concrete. So the concrete is graded according to its compressive strength, and as per Indian standard IS 456 Indian standard code, these are classified into various grades such as M5, M10, M15, M20, etc. So here this M stands for mix. Mix means it is the proportion of cement, sand and aggregate. It represents the proportion of cement, sand and aggregate, because concrete is the combination of cement, sand and aggregate. So here mix refers to the proportion, and this number represents the characteristic compressive strength of the cube. And what is the size of that cube? The size of that cube is 150 mm. So this number represents the characteristic compressive strength of cube, 150 mm cube, at 28 days, and it is expressed in terms of Newton per mm square. So this is the compressive strength which you have obtained at 28 days. And the size of the cube is, remember that it is 150 mm. So that strength is known as your characteristic compressive. So that is this number represent the compressive characteristic compressive strength of the cube at 28 days. Okay. Next, we will discuss about some advantages of reinforced cement concrete. So reinforced cement concrete, as you know, it has good compressive strength. So good compressive strength because of concrete. And RCC has high tensile strength because of steel. Then it has good resistance to damage by fire. And it protect the steel bars from buckling and twisting. It also prevent the steel from rusting, because it will act as a cover to the steel reinforcement. The reinforced concrete is durable and its maintenance cost is practically nil. So these are the different advantages of reinforced cement concrete. Then we will discuss about the different methods of design. So in RCC, we are having three different methods of design. The first one is working stress method, second one is ultimate load method, third one is limit state method. So let us first discuss about the working stress method. So this is the oldest method, and in this method is also known as your modular ratio method or elastic stress method, because in this method it is assumed that the concrete and steel are perfectly elastic. So here it is assumed that the concrete and steel are perfectly elastic, and in this method the moment and forces acting on a structure are computed from the actual values of service load. Okay, in this method the moment and forces that are acting on a structure has to be computed from the actual values of service load. The load that the structure which is subjected to the service load, from that we are calculating the moment and forces. And the stresses in concrete and reinforcing steel, here in this method the stresses in concrete and steel, because a steel and concrete both have some permissible values of stress. So in this case their stresses are restricted, and by providing some safety factor. So in this method a factor of safety of 3 is provided for concrete and 1.8 is provided for steel. Factor of safety is provided. So here a greater factor of safety is adopted for concrete, because the concrete is a brittle material. So in the event of failure, so concrete will crush unexpectedly. Therefore a higher factor of safety is considered for concrete. And steel, all of you know that steel is a ductile material, therefore it will give sufficient warning before failure. Okay, so in this method as the steel and concrete are assumed to be elastic one, but they are not actually perfectly elastic material, so this method of analysis do not give real behavior of the structure. Next we will go for the second method, that is ultimate load method. In this method the inelastic behavior of concrete is taken into account. Okay, here we have also assumed the inelastic behavior of concrete. Okay, and therefore the reserve strength of the concrete can be used, and this will lead to an economical design. As in case of working stress method we have considered that they are elastic material, but here as we have considered here the inelastic behavior of the concrete and steel, both material, so it will lead to an economical design. And this design, in this method the load on the structures, that is the structure, the load which is actually coming over the structure are increased by suitable load factors. And the structure is loaded with that increased load, which is called as ultimate load. And for material, for steel and concrete, the ultimate behavior are also taken into account. Hence, as the ultimate behavior of the material is taken and the load is factorized, this method leads to an economical design. But at the same time, it will produce very slender section, and there may be large deflection and large cracking will be there. Next method is limit state method. In limit state method, it based on limit state concept. That means the structure shall be designed to withstand safely all loads that is going to act on it throughout its life. And this method also satisfy the serviceability requirement. That means it should not allow excessive deflection and cracking. But in case of ultimate load method, it is not satisfactory at the deflection and cracking, because this design method leads to slender member, thin member. So there is no satisfactory serviceability requirement. And in WSM method, it gives for satisfactory performance at working load only, because it consider that the steel and it only consider the elastic behavior of steel and concrete. Therefore, it will give unrealistic results at ultimate state of collapse. And limit state method, the design values are derived from characteristic values by the use of partial factor of safety. Here we have used some partial factor of safety both for load as well as for material. Okay. In limit state method, we have used some partial factor of safety both for load as well as for material. So for load, the design load are obtained by multiplying some partial factor of safety for loads. In the similar manner, that means this load, that service load, is multiplied by some partial factor of safety in order to get the design load, which is used for the design of the structure. In case of limit state method, we are discussing about limit state method. And for material also, we have used some partial factor of safety in order to get the design strength. So this partial factor of safety are divided in the characteristic strength so as to get the design strength of the material. So this method is more logical, because it satisfies both the strength as well as serviceability requirement of a structure. Okay, the limitation of working stress method is that it consider only the elastic behavior of the material. The limitation of ultimate load method is ultimate load method do not satisfy the serviceability requirement. That is, it is not satisfying the deflection as well as cracking criteria. But this limit state method will consider the strength as well as serviceability criteria both. Therefore, most of the designs are nowadays, most of the structures are designed using this limit state method. So this is all about your different methods of design. And in our syllabus, we have both the design methods, working stress method as well as limit state method. So in the next class, we will go for the, in detail, we will study the working stress method. Thank you.